opposite if you're the other hand. So just taking a diagonal section, combing the hair up. This is going to be for the person who wants some length and movement on the top, but doesn't want to lose any length on the bottom. So I can let the length drop out. I'm going to be cutting short to long. So just angling my fingers so that I'm cutting short to long. I probably wet her down a little too soon.
Can I get you a bottom?
But thank you. Mm-hmm. Over directing to the previously cut section. Again, it's okay if the length drops out. Cutting short to long. Take my next section. Over directing forward. She should have eaten a cheeseburger so she had enough weight on her to hold her on this tripod. I can see my guide, but because I'm directing the hair forward, when it falls, it's not going to fall in that. I want my three layers. The layers are all going to move a little bit different. If you need to drop off the hair because it gets a bit much in the hair, that's fine, and then just go with your previously cut section. You will run out of hair. Once you get to right behind the ear.
Is that what you're doing? You're cutting the whole side right behind the ear?
Forward, yep. Once I get to behind the ear, this section here, I'm just going to grab a little bit of my previously cut section and use that as my guide. So I'm getting my weight out of the top.
So now you're no longer over-directing
it. No longer over-directing it. Just want to make sure you don't take too much out here and you want to shift it back. But I'm using this over-directed hair that came here is now my guide. I'm going to go to one pass center. When I say one pass center, meaning center back section. So it's not right dead on in the middle. I don't want to stop there. I always like my haircuts to go slightly like one past the center, going in either direction. So that would be one past center. Not really quite the middle of her head. And when I go back the other way, I'll go one past center on the other side just to make sure it all marries in together nicely. Easy, right? Mm-hmm. So when I get to the other side of the head, I now need to, in order to cut short to long, I need to switch my body position and stand in front of the head. My sections and everything would remain the same. I have a clue for my other side. So you're like, how do I start on a different side of the head in a different body position? You have your guide from your other side. That little piece of hair now can stay over here. I've already established my guides. She had ink works and conditioner in her hair at the hair show, and now you can pick little pieces of violet up with her hair. Well, told you she needed a cheeseburger on the way here. I'm still directing forward towards me because I directed forward when I was behind my work.
Can you turn that towards this way?
This way?
Just so we can see what you're doing. When you say you're directing it forward towards me, can you see that?
Section behind the ear. I didn't comb it all forward, I just used that previously cut section as my guide. So we talk about style options. This haircut gives me the great opportunity to talk whether it be smoothing or whether it be curling or texture or different style options within this haircut. It can certainly be blown out nice and smooth. You'll have a great layered haircut with some angling around the face, nice and smooth. That's one style option. But then I always ask for that permission to introduce another style option. That was quick and easy, right? I've got all the layers in. But if you layer it by over directing it and coming to that, you always end up with a little point right here, which tends to lay very fat on the bottom. Some textures here need the fatness on the bottom because it's so fine naturally that if you don't leave the weight, it will then look like it keeps needing to be cut shorter. Other people, this will give you that blend so you don't look like you have a layer and then the length. So just taking the point off, moving around the haircut shape, just combing it straight out. When I say straight out, just meaning straight up from where it lives. And cut that point. When I get to right behind the ear, I want to just go straight back to not create a hole right behind their ear, and you will run out of hair. And just repeat the steps on the other side, combing it straight out. Getting to this part, depending upon what the bottom's doing, like how much strength they want in the bottom, I always have a consultation with my longer hair or my layered hair clients. Do you like it to come to a point? Do we like a U-shape rounded, or do we like a square back? So I'm gonna put my design line in last. Totally a choice. If you wanna start this haircut, put it in first, because that's your habit. Put it in first, that's fine. Just make sure you keep the strength of the line when you're done. If they like the point in the back, I tend to comb everything at zero elevation forward. I'll put a center back section in. Zero elevation, comb all this forward, just using the head, wrapping it around. Because that hair, she's gonna run out of hair, but if this hair was long enough, because it was over directed to the front, when it went to the back, that center back section would be the longest piece, making it a point. If they want a rounded shape, when you're making a rounded shape, it's all about body position. If I wanted it square, then I would plant my feet and cut everything like there was still a box on their head. Everything would be combed down perfectly, and I'd cut a line right across the back. That's gonna give me a nice square line. If they want it rounded, it's kind of like a clock. You're gonna comb this section down, cut the center to the length you want, go from 6 to 7, from 7 to 8, and you're just gonna slightly have your fingers tilted. Same thing on the other side, depending upon what type of shape. Long hair clients, I always ask that question, because about the time I blunt off the back into a square line is when they say they want a point. Well, that now means they're going to be missing a couple inches up here to get the point back in the back. So just one of those key things that you're like, oh, probably should have asked that beforehand. consultation, and then sometimes you do it on somebody and then they're like, yeah, I didn't like the way it looks. It just kind of looks kind of icky, stringy down the bottom. So I'm going to use a couple products, and like I said, I'm going to multi-mix them because I like the fast form, and she's almost dry. So I'm going to use a little bit of the texturizing sea spray, and then a little bit of fast form, and this is where we're going to have a style consultation. She's not going anywhere. She just told me that she loved the way her hair felt when she came off the beach this weekend. It had that salt air in it, and it was just a little bit wavy and textured. My hair never has enough. So I'm going to show her. Just wind it and kind of scrunch it in. Certainly, our clients all know how to do this at home, right? But sometimes they don't realize things like this could be that easy.